गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फिट एंड फाइन एट होम. यस, आर यू रेडी फॉर द क्लास? यस. सो नाउ टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर एन इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट विद यू ऑल अबाउट मून. यस, मून इज सेड टू बी द ओनली नेचुरल सैटेलाइट ऑफ द अर्थ. सो मून इज सेड टू बी द ओनली नेचुरल सैटेलाइट ऑफ द Earth. While there are many such satellites in the solar system, it has the uniqueness of being the same size as the objects around which it orbits. So there are many such satellites in the solar system where there are uniqueness, like to whom it is orbiting, they are of the same size. Here are some more interesting facts about the moon that you need to know. So there are some more interesting facts which you should know about the moon, which I thought that I should share with you all as you are studying the chapter in geography. Yes, the moon is the second brightest object in the sky after the sun. So what is moon, students? The moon is the second brightest object in the sky after the sun. First is sun and second is the moon. The moon surface is like powder. So the moon surface is just like powder. It just looks like powder, which is called regolith. It is 100% dry. So the moon is 100% dry. The moon is about 238,900 miles away from Earth. It means that it is 384,000 kilometers away from Earth. So was it interesting? Yes, that the moon is the second brightest object in the sky after the sun. Were you knowing this? No, but now you are able to know that the moon is the second brightest object in the sky after the sun, and the moon surface is just like powder, which is called regolith. It is 100% dry, and the moon is about 384,000 kilometers away from the Earth, our planet Earth, where we are living. By this, let's start our social science class. And in social science, we are today studying geography. Yes, we have started geography, and in geography we have already started chapter number 1, and the name of the chapter is the Earth in the solar system. This we have started. Yes, in the earlier class, what we have done, let's recapitulate first. Okay, in the earlier chapter, we have studied about the sky at night, that how sky looks at night, how the stars come, you know, are being seen with the, from we see from the earth, how stars look. It seems as if the sky is stubborn, like a diamond. They all appear like they are twinkling. Some twinkle very brightly, some are very dim in light. They just simply glow without flickering, and just as moonshine. So they don't flicker, they don't twinkle. Along with these bright objects, you may also see at night moon. Yes, but in different days you can see moon in different shapes and position. These you can see the full moon only once about 1 month's time. So only in a month you can see full moon once, and there on that day it is called a full moon night or Purnima. That is known as full moon night or Purnima. At a fourth night, after 15 days of full moon night, after 15 days you can see it or it at all. You cannot see it at all. So there is no moon in the sky, and it is a new moon night or Amavasya, where you can see the sky very clear because there is no moon in the sky, and you can see the sky to the best, and the clear night you can see. Do you wonder why you cannot see the moon and all the objects, bright tiny objects, during daytime? Yes, because you cannot see the tiny objects which you saw at night in the daytime because of the sun, because of the sunlight of sun, because it is so high that all the objects which are there in the sky are not, we are not able to see them. Yes, because of the rays of the sun. Now we have also discussed about celestial bodies in our earlier classes. What are celestial bodies, students? Celestial bodies are the sun, the moon, and all those objects which are shining in the night sky. Which are shining in the night sky are called celestial bodies. Why we are saying that night sky? Because in daytime we are not able to see them. Yes. So we are saying celestial bodies are the sun, the moon, and all those objects shining in at the night are called celestial bodies. Some celestial bodies are very big and hot. They have their own heat and light, and they are made up of gases, and they also emit large amount of heat and light. These celestial bodies are called stars. Like those celestial bodies which are very big and hot and are made up of gases, and they have their own heat and light which they emit in large quantity. Though these type of celestial bodies are called stars. Now you understand what are stars? A sun is a star. So a sun is also a star. Countless twinkling stars in the night sky are similar to the sun. So, but we do not feel their heat or light, and they look tiny because they are very far away from us. As we can see, if we notice that the aeroplane is flying in the sky, and from the earth, if we see aeroplane in very small size, yes, but aeroplane is in very large size originally. So like that only we are able to see the stars in very tiny, size. Why? Because they are very far away from us. Yes, while watching the night sky, you may notice various patterns formed by different groups of stars. These patterns are known as constellations. So you can see here, these are constellations which are forming a different pattern. So these stars which are forming different patterns are called as constellations. Ursa Major or Big Star or Big Bear is one of such constellations. So you can see here in the sky, you can notice Ursa Major or Big Bear. Such constellation in a form of Big Bear is known as Ursa Major. There is Saptarishi also, one of the most easily recognizable constellation is Saptarishi. So if you want to recognize constellation in the night sky, so the easiest recognizable constellation is Saptarishi. Sapt means seven and Rishi means sages. It is a group of seven stars, so there are seven stars in Saptarishi that form a part of Ursa Major constellation. So see how it looks like. Ask someone elders in your family to show you the Ursa Major or the Saptarishi constellation in the sky. They will help you to see the Saptarishi constellation in the sky. Yes, in ancient times, how people were able to determine the direction during the night? They were able to determine the direction during night with the help of stars. They were able to determine the direction with the help of North Star, which indicates the north direction, and it was stable at the same position. It was not moving here and there, and this North Star is also called as Pole Star. So this is a pole star which shines so brightly, and it is always towards the north. It is towards the north direction always, and by this only people were able to know the directions. It always remain in the same position in the sky. We can locate the position of the pole star with the help of Saptarishi constellation. How it happens? Let's see here. It is a pole star. Yes, we are not able to see the pole star first. First, we will recognize the Ursa Major. Here is Ursa Major Saptarishi. Seven stars, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these are seven stars, and it just looks like a spoon shape. These two are the pointer stars, and towards the north of the pointer star, you will see the pole star. So if you will see the point star, and towards the north, it is a pole star, and pole star is also known as the North Star. With the help of this North Star, the people in ancient time were able to see the direction, to know about the direction, that if this is north direction, it means this will be the south, this will be the west, and this will be the east direction. Some celestial bodies do not have their own heat and light. They are lit by light of the stars. So some of the celestial bodies do not have their own heat and light. They lit from the planets only. Yes, and these celestial bodies who do not have their own heat and light, and they live with the help of the light of the stars. These type of celestial bodies are known as planets. So now you understood, students, what are planets? Planets are the celestial bodies only which do not have their own heat and light, and they take their heat and light with the help of the stars. And those celestial bodies which take their heat and light with the help of stars, they lit with the help of stars, are known as planets. The word planets come from the Greek word planetia, which means wanderers. So the word planet comes from the Greek word planetia, which means wanderers. Yes, you can see sun here. Now, if we talk about planet, the earth is on which we live is a planet. We all know that the earth is a planet. It gets all its heat and light from the sun, which is our nearest star. So you can see here, the earth is here and it takes heat and light with the help of sun. Sun is a star. If we look at the earth from a great distance, say the moon, it will appear to be shining just as the moon. So if we look earth from a greater distance, if suppose we see earth from the moon, if we are standing on the moon and we want to look towards the earth planet, it will just shine just as a moon only. It will look just like a moon only. So earth is here, moon is here. If we are standing on moon and we are looking towards to the earth, it will just look like a moon only. It will shine just like a moon only. The moon that we see in the sky is a satellite. Yes, this we discussed in earlier class, that the moon that we see in the sky is a satellite. And what is a satellite, students? Satellite is, we will discuss in the other slide. Yes, it is a companion of our earth and moves around it. So how you can see, moon is a satellite and it is just orbiting or just revolving around the earth. So this what does this satellite means? Let's understand. A satellite is a celestial body only that moves around the planets in the same way as the planets move around the sun. So what is a celestial body? Celestial body is a satellite is a celestial body that moves around the planet. It moves around the planet just in the same way like planet move around the sun. So you can see here how this moon is, you know, revolving round the earth. It is revolving round the planet. That is why the moon is called as a satellite. And here the earth is revolving round the sun, which shows that the planet earth is a satellite of the sun. For example, earth is a satellite because it orbits the sun, because it is revolving around the sun. So what is a satellite now? Now you understood. A satellite is a celestial body that moves around the planet in the same way as the planet moves around the sun. For example, earth is a satellite because it orbits the sun. Likewise, the moon is a satellite because it orbits the earth. Yes. Now, why these satellites are there? Usually, the word satellite refers to a machine that is launched into space and move around the earth. So, usually, how you know that what is a satellite? You know only the satellite that it is a machine that launches into the space and moves around the earth for another body in the space. But these satellites, which are used as a machine, that are human made, man made satellites. Yes. So there are natural satellites also, like moon is a natural satellite. The man-made satellites are just in a way of machine which are being launched into space and move around the earth or another body in space. But why these satellites are being launched in the space, or why they are being, you know, sent on the in the space or to rotate around the earth or other planets in the space, why it happens? You can see how satellite is revolving around the planet Earth. Now, a human-made satellite is an artificial body. Most artificial satellites orbit Earth. Why it orbits Earth? Because these satellites are being sent on space to gather the information about universe or about the forecast, weather forecast, about the telephone calls or about ocean, navigation of ships and aircrafts, monitor crops and other resources and support military activities. that from there they can watch on the active military activities of in different areas, and they can click the pictures from there, and they can send to the with the help of computers, they can send to the research department. Now it is carried by a rocket and placed in the orbit around the Earth. Now how satellite is being placed in the space? It is being carried with the help of rockets and placed in the orbit around the Earth. What is orbit? Orbit is a way. Yes, it is a way on which the satellites or the planets move. It is a fixed path. Yes, orbit means it is a fixed path around which the planets revolves around the Earth, and the revolves around the Sun, and the Moon revolves around the Earth. Some of the Indian satellites in space are INSAT, IRIS, EduSat, etc. Like our Earth, there are 7 other planets that get heat and light from the Sun. So, like our planet Earth, there are 7 other planets that get heat and light from the Sun. Some of them have their own moons too. So, like our Earth, there are 7 other planets that get heat and light from the Sun. Some of them have their moons too. Now we will talk about today's topic. And what is today's topic, students? Today's topic, we will talk about the solar system. So we will discuss about the solar system. The Sun, 8 planets, satellites, and some other celestial bodies known as asteroids and meteoroids form the solar system. So what is solar system? Solar system is the Sun, 8 planets, satellites, and some other celestial bodies known as asteroids and meteoroids, which are there in the space, which are there in the universe, form the solar system. We often call it as a solar family. Why we call it as a solar family? Because Sun is a head of this family, and in the family there are 8 planets, satellites are there, and some other celestial bodies are there, which are known as asteroids and meteoroids. Yes, you can see here, this is Sun, and there are 8 planets here in this which are revolving around the Sun, which makes a family of solar sun, and which are known as solar system. And there are some celestial bodies also which are present there in the form of asteroid and meteoroids. Now the solar system, this is a picture of a solar system, students. So here we have Sun, and the 8 planets are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars. Yeah, these are asteroid belts which we were talking about. So these are also the part of a solar system family. Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, Pluto. Pluto before 2006 August, Pluto was also a planet part of the solar system. It was a planet which was a part of a solar system. Earlier there were 9 planets, yes, but now there are 8 planets only, because now after 2006 August, Pluto was considered as a dwarf planet, which was not having which was having the light in very low it was having a very low light, and because of that it was being considered as a dwarf planet. And now after 2006 August, now in the solar system there are only 8 planets. And which are those 8 planets? Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. These are the planets which are a part of a solar system, and Sun is a head of the family. Sol in Roman mythology is the sun god. So what does Sol means? Why the solar system name came from? The solar system name came from, solar came from Sol. In Roman mythology, it is known as sun god. Solar means related to sun. So solar means whatever things which are related to sun. The family of the sun is therefore called the solar system. Yes. So now we will do a recapitulation of the chapter. So today, students, what we have studied? We have studied about celestial bodies. We have studied about moon. We have studied about the stars. What are stars? Stars are the celestial bodies which have their own heat and light. We have discussed about the sun. Sun is a celestial body. Yes. And the sun is a star. Yes, sun is a star. Yes, and we have also discussed about the solar system. That was the solar system. In a solar system, sun is a head, and there are 8 planets and celestial bodies are there, which are known as asteroid and meteoroids. Yes, which are there, which are the part of the solar system. Till this we have discussed. So what is the homework for you? What you have to do? Write down as many words using the word solar. So what you have to do, students, you have to write down as many words which you think should come, which starts with solar, which in which the solar word comes on your own as you can. Yes, read geography book page number 2 and 3. Whatever today we have discussed till now, you have to read the book so that whatever queries you are having, you can just discuss them in the online classes. Students, geography is a new subject for you. Yes, and this chapter is also new for you. So what you have to do, you have to read the book very thoroughly, and then whatever queries you are having, you can ask me in the online class session. Yes, till then, thank you and have a nice day, students.